about to see is a series of video clips shot during the year 2010 at Sunnyside Yard. I've left the music out, merely giving you the sounds and the scenes taken at various times during the year. This is looking at the west end of the yard, January the 6th, 2010. The cameras used were various. Sometimes it was a GoPro, sometimes it would be my cell phone, other times a JVC camcorder or a Nikon. Here comes a nice flyby by the Long Island Railroad. We were sitting on sub 1 at the time. That's main line 2 going by now. This is a New Jersey Transit push-pull coming down sub 2 on its way down to the home signal waiting for railroad into New York, Penn Station. 4600 is head out. Very close clearance between sub 1 and sub 2, as you can see. Right now, we're sitting on an Empire train, I believe, or it might be train 43. In fact, I think it's train 43 on sub 1. And that's looking west. Another transit push-pull coming out of New York, headed for the loop tracks, going eastbound, as seen from sub 1. There's a trailing engine right there on the transit. Here's a P-32 laying on 5-track in the station in New York from the Empire service, waiting for the yard. I believe this is the 706. And an Amtrak train sitting over on 6-track, getting ready to leave New York. Now we're just panning across the yard looking east. The yard master.
Good morning, we have the 3609 pulling 9, over. 3609 with 9. That's a roger. Been on 23 today, 23. 23, we have anything leaving?
Inbound and a runner.
Inbound and a runner, thank you, sir. 23.
Heading west on sub 1, train 43 on its way into New York. Look back to the east. coming off the 17 track, eastbound, headed for the S&I building. That would be a service and inspection building. That equipment will run out to the loop tracks. It'll get in the clear on the loop tracks, and then they'll reverse and come back in for the high speed building. That's the high speed building on the left. We'll pan down, we'll catch the trailing unit as it goes by. Here's a P32701 laying in the yard, February the 6th, head end to train 233. Note the steam coming up. Now we're eastbound on the loop tracks. This is February the 12th. I didn't take video every single day, that's why it's spaced out the way it is. The months of June, July, August, I didn't take much video at all. That's not to say I don't have a lot of still photographs taken during that time, but I've used all the time so far with this pandemic to go through my video files and try to sort things out, so I've pretty much broken them down for 2007, 2009, all the way through 2019. This is part of the east side access. There's construction work going on. Here's the west end yard drill. This is February the 14th. I decided not to add any music track because I've had a number of subscribers complaining about the fact that the music drowns out the sounds of the railroad, which they prefer listening to, and I tend to agree. It's nice to have the chatter in the background. It's the East End drill, also February 14th, making a move east. That blue building in the back is the high-speed rail facility. It's also our switching center, and the yardmaster, East End yardmaster, is located in that building.
Hey, Frank, 280. I forgot to tell you, motor 713.
East End drill coming back in to make a hitch.
Up is 3 and AM NP4. 5 cars, 572.
Western MP4.
MP4, Frank. 2 cars, 572.
Frank, that's train 19, operate 19-030.
Here's a transit. I'm leaving for New York, February the 14th. Coming off the runner. Just to the right of your picture is where the demolition's taking place on Building 2 for the coming East Side Access Project. In the far distance, in the left, you can see a lot of the work has already begun. This is the West End drill making a drill move with the road engine. That would be the P-32 that's head out.
Hello, Angie. Hello, Chu.
Hello?
We're good on 36.
Okay, thanks. I was doing 5.
1-3-9-1, radio check.
Ground radio.
Thank you.
This is the conductor talking to the engineer on the 712, which is the lead motor on this move.
Hello, Ethan.
Yes, Ethan.
Frank, anything on 18 or 20?
Okay, now we're on a high-speed set in a cellar train coming off of Loop A. We're on the move west. That is me talking to my engineer. And we're going to bring him in for SNI 2. Safety stop. And we've already had permission from the foreman in charge to enter the building. And we're on our way in. Notice the catwalks to the right. That's for going above the equipment, checking out pantographs. Central platform is for loading and unloading materials. And of course, you've got the inspection pit below for changing out brake shoes, etc. As the steps going down, so you can go under the train into the center. Now we'll get a spot from the foreman. Here it is.
Five, wind up, post derail. One quad, T4, one truck.
This is looking at the undercarriage on the train we just brought into SNI-2. Give you an idea of what it looks like. Let's see an Acela on the move, shall we? Here he comes. Line 2 for New York. We're laying on sub 2 right now. And here she comes. Q Tower. This is where your block operator is located on the West End. This was taken February 28th. Operator at Q is the man that releases the trains out of the yard. Get a very nice view of the main line from up here. There's an eastbound Long Island headed for Jamaica. There's a catenary maintenance vehicle down below. Model board at Q. And of course you've got the levers sitting down below. Those control the switches and the signals in the yard. There's our daylight operator. Through that doorway used to be the West End Yardmaster's office, but they've moved everything to the East End now, up to the switching center at R in the blue building. Here's an outbound train with an HHP on the head end. And 19 is waiting for 241, permission by a stop signal. Engineer's given the repeat back to the operator and he'll be on the move. Here's a cab car on transit push-pull. There's a 4616, another transit train. Transit multiple unit train leaving the yard, heading down toward the subs on March the 3rd. On the move. Out of line one for the loops. P32 will be doing a change over here, going from third rail up back over to diesel. P32s are all dual mode locomotives. Here's the West End drill on the 1st of April, making a drill move with a road engine.
Pause up, man. 14. Pause up. 914 on the point.
Yeah.
No approach to restricting 10 cars. Okay.
Who is that?
Radio check 7047.
Train 171 on the move outbound for New York Penn. HHP 650 on the head end. This is the scene where they've been demolishing Building 2, April 1st. That building stood from, it was built in 1910, so lasted 100 years until they tore it down. Time marches on. Disappearing Railroad Blues. Sunnyside, plenty of trains in the yard.
No, don't make the cut yet, Tyrone, don't make the cut.
Ah, the rumble of a P-32 running on sub 1, April the 15th. They've already gone through the changeover. They'll pick up third rail on the subs. Here we are, we're pacing a Long Island, headed into Hunters Point Station. Long Island also had dual mode locomotives. They could run them into New York on third rail, or the eastbound trains would run using the diesel once they cleared Jamaica. If you look in the background, you'll see the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus. More of the circus train. Laid up for storage. The circus was in town, I assume. This was a perfect day for taking video. Bright sunshine, and again we see another Long Island coming out, heading eastbound for Jamaica. A trailing move, which I especially liked. Citibank building in the background. You can see, I believe that's the Empire State Building in the distance. You'll see a freight train going up the Montauk Cutoff. They run freight down over into Brooklyn. That would be the Atlantic Railway, I believe. This is the Eastside Access Project, May the 22nd. They're excavating ground from what they're going to be the Q-tip. An integral part of their grand design. That required them to destroy buildings, I believe, 5 and 6, which were done, I believe, in 2009. They took those down to start the big dig here. This now has all been covered over. The work there is moving along pretty well, but don't forget, this was 10 years ago. Here I am walking on foot, taking a look at the progress on this Eastside Access. I'm walking down to the area that's called the Q-tip, October the 2nd. That building there was put up for one reason only, manufacturing the concrete to be used for the project. That was its sole purpose. They put it up, and when they were done, they took it all down. This is the Q-tip right here. I'm looking at it. They'll be boring three tunnels through that wall on the left. This is just looking straight down. See, this is what you can do with a GoPro. You put it on a selfie stick and you just put it right over the edge. to North Runner and the inbound motor track. Here's the view from the operating cab on a Harrisburg train heading for the washing machine. October the 3rd. Engineer is Rocky. Got a video at somewhere on my my YouTube site of a cab car. But this just gives you an idea what it looks like when you're in the control seat running. That switch you were coming up on was not the A loop. Eastbound Long Island train, November the 23rd. Quiet, I'm doing something. Flyby, Long Island Railroad. Sheen from Sub 2. Here's a little look at an AEM-7, the FN, from the operating cab. Locomotive was 941. Well, these are no longer in service either. They cut all of these up. This would be the trailing unit on a Harrisburg push-pull. November the 28th. To the yard. That's the Kelly track on the right, as we say goodbye to New York. This was taken from the last car on the train. I opened up the door and was shooting out the back as we headed east. December the 1st. It's coming around the loops. There's a double header. December the 2nd. We'll be interested for any comments you might have as to whether or not you enjoyed this. I do have other video from 2007, 2009, 2011, 2012, I believe. But I plan on posting all of it with no music in the background because there were a few people that really wanted to just hear the sounds of the railroad. Here we have the S&I building on the right. The projection off the front of the building, which is coming up, is where the east end yard mast sits. He can look through the windows and survey all this is in his control. Also have the operator up there controlling switches on the east end of the yard. I have video of this one. When they were building this, I've got video clips of that of it going up. Yeah, there's the 709. Take a little look, see what the running gear looks like on this puppy. December the 5th, Christmas is coming. More than likely, this was my iPhone taking this video. Since then, I've gotten myself a very nice gimbal, but that's a little bit ostentatious to use in the yard. They're not big on photography. Although I will say a number of my friends, former railroad friends, do enjoy watching my videos, and they're happy that I was able to record a lot of this footage because things have greatly changed over the years. That structure to the right is the basement from the old F Tower. We're on sub 1 and we're headed west for line 2. Train is 2:33, December the 12th. We're looking back here. That rail is line 2. See, there's the basement there. That was the old F Tower. There's a staircase from the bridge above. I've got still photos of F, and I got a little bit of video, but not much. Yeah, here's a look inside the S&I building. Directly ahead, SMI-1, to the left, SMI-2, December the 14th. Had a little snow the end of December, more of a blizzard. This is after the big snow in 2010. December the 29th. Beautiful day, a little cold, but excellent for taking video. A This is at the west end of the yard, looking east, just doing a slow pan across. And since it's December 29th, we're running out of the year here, so we're going to be wrapping this up very shortly. Oops, that's a little shaky on that one. On sub 1, waiting for railroad. That structure to the rear is the Long Island jump over. And we're on the move, westbound. December the 29th, 2010. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Took me a while to put all the bits and pieces together, but I hope it's smoothed out enough that you'll enjoy it. If so, feel free to give me a thumbs up. I'll try to post a few more when I get around to it. I've got time on my hands since everybody is indoors. Stay safe in the pandemic, please.